I'm Marina Mabrey. I'm a guard for the Chicago Sky.
Step back for Mabrey, and she hits.
People know me as a fierce competitor. I do anything to win. Sometimes when I feel like people are getting in my way, I can get a little bit spicy. Sometimes it can come off aggressively. To me, I just have that fiery mentality. Like, I want to win. The competitive spirit that I have comes from my family. I feel like my childhood is what made me who I am today. We would play against each other in all kinds of sports, but like basketball was the most competitive. We would really be serious out there, playing 2-on-2, 1-on-1, anything we could compete against each other. My siblings all played college basketball. Yeah, I have some middle child syndrome a little bit, but like I'm not the worst middle child there is. In my earlier years in the league, I was good and I had a high skill level. I got myself in shape, but there was something mentally missing. Like, I struggled emotionally like throughout the game. Like, anytime it didn't go my way, I would get really upset, like have to come out of the game and sit and think about it. Feeling all of those emotions and not being able to just like ground them was tough to like keep my focus. Just watching my reactions emotionally to things, I realized there was something that I had to change. I started finding ways to ground myself, to understand self-love, self-care. I never lost my edge. Like, I am who I am, but I feel like when I became more in tune with myself and aware, I started to channel it into more successful things for me. So kind of being a competitor, but also keeping my cool, keeping my emotions, especially when it gets really hot. Sometimes you can be physical and you want to make sure that they have to defend at a high level, understanding that people are going to come out and try to take the ball from me and try to rough me up a little bit. And like every night, somebody's going to try to stop you from doing what you do.
Diamond to Shields, throws Mabrey down.
People come out and they're ready to play against me. Like, they're determined to stop me. So I need to like put my body in the best position to be successful against all that physicality. I'm doing ice bath. I'm gonna switch back and forth from hot to cold for contrast, like circulation. My first year, I barely did any treatment. Then as soon as I started playing like heavy minutes and like people were getting more physical trying to stop me and stuff, like I was getting way more sore. Like, it's a physical sport and get ready to get hit and hit back. Starts in the ice bath, baby. Okay, I'm doing cryotherapy. I feel like it's self-explanatory, it's freezing. But I like the energy boost that I get from it. We got 1:10 left. We're testing my mental toughness today.
I'm gonna do some red light therapy now. I feel like it's a form of self-care, like, not to get like too philosophical here, but like, you know, the God, the universe, whatever you wanna call it, gave you this one body to reach your fullest potential and your purpose. And you wanna take care of it because it's the only one that you have, and this is what you're using to operate. If you don't take care of it, whatever is meant for you and is supposed to be for you, it's gonna be harder to reach. So, just trying to take care of the one body I was given.
Today is game day. I am a creature of habit, as I do the same things every morning.
I meditate every single day. And I know it sounds like cliche, but like I light all these candles because I wanna go out there and shine my light every day. Since I incorporated like mindfulness, meditation, journaling, I'm much more grounded emotionally. And one thing that I love about journaling and being able to look back at the progress I've made, I can't believe I was performing at the level that I was. It's been a real challenge, like emotionally and mentally, but after you go through it and let it all like come up and let it all come out, like, you feel so much more in tune with yourself and knowing we're not our thoughts, we're not our emotions. And then like the yoga and Pilates, I feel like I'm moving my body, like I feel good, I feel energized. That stuff to me is what drives my performance.
I feel like I'm two different people. On the court, you see a completely different version of me, and then off the court, I'm almost the opposite.
Stay in the ball. Once another person come and kick you down.
Kobe always talked about like an avatar that he would tap into like before games and go into like this meditative state where he was gonna get into the zone. Marina is like my avatar.
You want me to go straight behind you? My man's gonna follow me all the way there.
And I always say basketball is kind of like acting. Like, I become this person when I walk in that maybe I'm not that person really in real life, but if it drives me to my best performance, then that's who I'm gonna be today. So Rena will get activated probably around like 3 to 15 when I'm about to leave. I wanna dominate like the second I get into the gym, and if that means like my outfit's on point, then I already started dominating when I walked in.
Done, and we get out of here and we play a good game tonight. Let's go.
Right now in my journey, I feel like I'm like just scratching the surface and blossoming into who I can be.
Oh, you babies!
The awareness of who you can be, if the time is right and then you put the work in and trust yourself, you can take yourself as far as you believe you can. I want to be one of the best players in the world, and I think that's what I can be, and somebody that wins championships. And for me, I feel like I'm just getting started and I have so much to learn and so much to build off of mentally and physically and just like experience wise that I can't wait to see what's in store for me.
Mabrey posts it up, it's counting. Uses that right arm to get around her and scores. Mabrey is on fire tonight.